It was difficult to imagine that in the summer of 1992, the old biology lab, which had been built by Warden Sobey, was soon to be removed. It seemed so much a part of the landscape that its disappearance in 1993 was very noticeable to everyone in the college. Old Columbans will remember the bare blank walls and the many hours sitting on this fine construction, watching TV on many's the wet afternoon. But even to the most sympathetic eye, the room had become shabby and dishevelled. It was time for a new beginning. Soon, all that was left were the remains of the lonely steps up the Cadogan. The ruins of the demolished building looked more like a bomb site than the beginnings of a new library. The decision to build a new library was taken in 1992 by the present warden, Timothy Macy, in consultation with the fellows of the college. There was a great scepticism when the project was first announced, and the plans were exhibited at the 150th anniversary celebration. A sum of £500,000 was required to cover this mammoth project.
The work began with only part of the full capital which was required, but with a great deal of faith and hope and expectation in the charity of those connected with the college. A development office was set up and the school set about the arduous task of fundraising. John Somerville-Large, an old Columban, was appointed as overall architect. He submitted a large number of ambitious and interesting designs for the new library. After much deliberation amongst the fellows and staff, a final decision was taken early in 1993. Allen and Smith builders from Arklow were chosen by the college to construct the new library, and Mr. Chris Lyons from Collin Construction oversaw the whole project. The engineering was undertaken by Brian Geraghty and Associates, and the furniture was to be supplied by John Jobling Purser. But all this seemed so far away as foundations were being dug and cement was being transported to establish the very foundations of the new building. Beresford was surrounded by a muddy mire. The young girls could only enter the building from the rear. Right through the winter, they plodded their way between the fellows' building and founders, up along muddy paths, sometimes through the pouring rain. But, bit by bit, the building began to take shape. The empty space began to take form. Out of the nothingness began to grow a beautiful building. The dream was becoming a reality.
Seasons passed. Summer, autumn, winter. And eventually spring, leading to the following summer and the completion of the library. The library was officially owned by Mr. Bruce Arnold, literary editor of the Irish Times. Amongst the guests was Caroline Gray, a professional librarian. She seems happy enough. We were also delighted to see Mr. John McEnany, former development officer to the college. But it was the Warden's Day. What a magnificent achievement for Mr. Timothy Macy. Now comfortably nestled beside the big schoolroom, it is hard to remember a time when the library wasn't there. The whole building seems to blend in so naturally with the earlier architecture.